Hi guys, it's Natalie. Welcome to my channel. How's everyone doing? It's Tuesday. Is it Tuesday? I shouldn't even talk about what day it is because who knows when I get this out. As I said, squeak. My eyebrow is like all the way over there. Oh, and BT Dubs, actually I did my eyebrows lighter today, but not because someone told me, because I needed to just for the purpose of the makeup I was doing today. I personally wanted to. I know they're still super dark, but I even usually do them darker when I do an eye look, and somebody like commented on that, and let me tell you something. I can see, I obviously know that my eyebrows are ridiculously dark and they look disgustingly terrible with my makeup, but I just don't care. Like, I don't care. When I do an eye look, I want my eyebrows to look like that for some of my eye looks, for most of them. And I do my makeup and then I get on here and I talk to you and I know that they're the wrong color. But as I said, I don't care. How about that? How about that? I just don't care. So anywho, here we go. Guys, guess what? Okay. So, Laura Lee Los Angeles, when I first saw her products come out, it's not that, I don't have a problem with Laura, she's whatever to me. I actually don't mind her. I went up and down with her, and now I'm at a place where I honestly, it's like, girl, do your thing. I respect her. I've got no problems with the girl. Her brand, when the stuff was coming out at first, I was like, not really my thing. Like, when I look at Manny's palette, that's more me than Laura's stuff. But then, when she just had this little launch of these two mini palettes that were super colorful, I was like, oh girl, yes. Like, for one, the price was amazing. I believe they're like, oh, I don't even know what I'm doing here. Like, I'm losing my mind. I thought they were both super colorful. So the Boss Babe is $19. And then the Party Animal is $19. And if you buy them together, it's only $30. Which I was like, oh, sign me up. So that's what I did. If I could get inside the box, I would look at them. Oh honey, you taped this box up. These came wrapped pretty good, so I'm having high expectations. I am literally shook, and I never use that word. Okay, this is gorgeous. Laura, yes, 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 yes. I gotta talk crap though real quick. Just let me talk crap really quickly and then I'm good. Her logo, everything about it, that's maybe for another video. I can't with it. I'm sorry, I just can't. That's for another video. Anyway, and I was a marketing major, so I don't wanna hear it when people say like I'm talking crap. I'm honestly coming from my point of view, like what I think looks good and catches people's eye. I do not think this logo has it at all. But Laura, this packaging, and I also don't understand, like, you got this going on, then you got that. They're two separate things, but like, it's too much. They don't coincide with each other. Anyway, okay, I'm done with that. This packaging is freaking amazing. So it says Boss Babe and Party Animal, and the one side is the Boss Babe and the other side is the Party Animal. It has little pull tabs, so you could just pull it out like this. And it also opens up like this. And it says, is a party and hustle hard. And honestly, this is my favorite packaging I've ever gotten. I can honestly say that, like, for the price point, if she's able to do this, starting this brand from literally nothing, she is small time compared to these big makeup companies and compared to Kylie. Like, if she's able to do this and keep the price point at $30, I don't want to hear an excuse for these other companies that charge. I don't want to hear it. Like, seriously, this is amazing. Like, you go, Laura. I am highly impressed by this. So it has a little pull thing. We're able to open it like this. Now the actual shadows are very small, so I'm interested to see what they look like inside. I knew they were gonna be small, but I didn't think they were gonna be this small. I'm actually interested, if you were to order one of these, does it just come like this for $19? Like, so then you get this better packaging. I don't know. Oh, okay. So they actually are a decent size. I don't know why I was expecting them to be a lot smaller. This palette is adorable. It has an awesome size mirror for the size of the packaging. You get 6 colors and the shades are listed right on them, which I also like. Let me open the other one so we'll have them both out and we will just swatch right down the row, okay? So this is Boss Babe. I actually know exactly what I'm doing. And we got these. So I'm gonna start with Boss Babe and I'm gonna swatch them. So first we have On the Grind, which is a nice gold shimmer metallic. We have Deadline, which is a light brown matte. These are nicely pigmented. We have CEO, which is a gorgeous, gorgeous rose gold color. These are pretty. We have 9 to 5. Which is a matte brownish, reddish, like, what is that? What is the word I'm trying to think of to describe that color? Then we have Hustler, which is a gold shimmer, which, oh, wow. Okay, Laura, like, you were like, okay, haters, like, I'm coming for you with this palette. And then we have Clocked Out. Honest to God, guys, like, I did not have high hopes for this at all. And I'm gonna be honest, like, with her products. And I'm blown away by this. I mean, we gotta see how they perform on the eye. This one looks like it's gonna be patchy. It does, but overall, I'm thoroughly impressed so far. Thoroughly impressed. We're gonna jump into this, and I'm just gonna swatch. I'm gonna just keep going down the line. So we're gonna do Is a Party, which is a matte neon. That looks like it's gonna be very hard to work with, but these colors are hard colors to formulate. So I'm not gonna talk crap just yet. Damage Control, which is a matte blue. And that's a gorgeous color. Oh, I'm loving that even more on than in the pan. Next we have Karaoke. Oh, honey, yes! We have Drinks, which is a matte orange. And you know what, Karaoke, it's really hard to see, but it actually has like glitter in it. But you can't really see that, so we'll have to check out how that is on the eye. Bottoms Up, which is this. Okay. Wow, that's a pretty one. And then we have Hungover, which is a deep, I don't even know how to describe this. A deep purple plum, but it's like a metallic, but it almost has like blue tones in it. Ooh. Very iridescent. Check out these colors. To me, this is a palette. This right here is the palette. Yes, Laura, you did it with your packaging and your shade range. I will give you that. I'm a little scared to work with these, though. I'm not going to lie. Yeah, just... Okay, we'll see. We might just work with this palette because... Hey guys, I have been wanting to retry this, like, look that I did. What's it called? Like a tie-dye. It turned out okay. I had a little bit of trouble, and it was actually, it's because this one shade, here, I'll show you, like, the yellow, I just can't really, it doesn't show up as well. So I'm having some issues with it. I'm not gonna mess with it anymore because I'm gonna make it worse. But other than that, yeah, it's not bad. I was gonna use the other palette on the other eye, but you know what? I think I'm just gonna do another crazy look on this side. We'll stick to this palette because let me tell you something. If this Party Animal palette works good, then that says something, because these colors are a lot harder to do and make good shadows with than the other palette. So I feel like this will give us an indication of what we're working with. I know what I'm gonna do. Actually, I don't really. Okay, I'm gonna take my good old trusty blending brush and I'm gonna grab this orange. No, I'm gonna grab this yellow. And I'm just gonna like start packing. But I have some trouble with it like blending away. And then same brush. We're gonna dip into the orange. And come down the line. Ooh. And then we're going to take a new brush because we're diving into blue, and we're going to take this matte blue damage control, pack that on out here. Now see, this is patchy. And then I'm going to take my yellow again. Now I need a new brush because I done messed this up. Go back in there with this orange because I do like this bright orange though. Ooh. And then take this blue again on the end. Okay, so we are gonna take bottoms up and we're gonna do a cut crease first of all. Okay, so I cut my crease and I laid the pink down. How pretty is that pink though? I'm not gonna lie, this palette, the colors are not the easiest to work with. I've worked with easier colors. They're very chalky. Sometimes chalky's not bad, but I don't necessarily know if these ones are chalky in an amazing way or not, or if it's like detrimental is what I should say. I don't mind them. It's definitely not my favorite. Let's just leave it at that. So I'm gonna combine this pink into this like duochrome purple, which is gonna be pretty, pretty. And then I'm gonna take this brush that I used and go into the darker blue and just like fade those into each other. We're gonna figure something out because this look, I'm not living. I am not living for it, but they're fun though, I guess. I don't know. I'm not living It's a cute palette. It's a cute palette. I'm not living for the quality. It could be better. I would prefer better quality, less packaging. How about that? That's what we'll go with. The quality could be better. Okay, so I'm gonna go off camera and finish this up. I know my eyes look crazy, but I shall be right back and we will talk. Okay, I finished up the look. I did this tie-dye look on the one eye. It's probably like fading by now. I added a little bit of like highlight into the center, but I really like these shadows are not as pigmented on the eye as I thought they were gonna be. My lips, yes, I know, are crazy. It's glow in the dark. I'm gonna have to show you guys in another video how it glows because it's daylight right now and I don't know how to make my lips dark. I don't know how to make the sky dark, not... Okay, anyway. Anywho, this is by that incredible Listen Hard Girl. It doesn't go on very well. It's very patchy, but this is something for more like a party or for like a specific purpose. Well, obviously, if you're buying neon glow-in-the-dark lip paint, but I like sometimes forget that not everyone's like me. It's just crazy looks all the time. So the other eye, I did a cut crease. As you can see, I did the pink, the purple, dark blue, and then right above it, I did like the yellowish, the neon like yellow, into the orange, into the lighter blue, and then that like wrapped around into the dark blue. These colors, they're good. They could be better. That like, honestly, overall, I'm very happy with this entire purchase for the money. I think it's great. I think it's a great presentation. I think the product is good. Do I think there is room for improvement? Yes, I do. But for the price point, I think it's awesome. I truly do. Laura, awesome work. I think you did great. I like everything about this one. I really do. I think, as I said, I think for the price point, you're doing an awesome job. I felt like a little bit of an issue with like the pink, specifically kind of like blending away. Patchy, but... Have you ever had a shadow that it just doesn't stay, like the vibrancy leaves very quickly once you start working with it? That's how I felt. But overall, as I said, I added a little bit of highlight on top of it because I just felt like it needed a little something extra. But honestly, Laura, awesome work. Okay, I need to just wrap this up. Awesome work, girl. Look, my nails and everything like went with it. So anywho, you know the drill, like the video, subscribe to the channel, head to the Insta to check out my two, not one, but two giveaways. We got makeup, we got skincare. Woo. Okay, all right, that's it. Okay, yeah, overall A plus or like A minus or like something, Laura, like I really liked it. Guys, I think it's a great, I think if you're looking for some fun, it's a great buy for the money. And that's all I got. Love you, bye.